Hi, beautiful Gemini. Welcome to my channel. My name is Katie. Today I'm going to be doing your reading for the first week of July from the 1st to the 7th. So let's see what messages are available for you, Gemini. Let's see what do you need to keep in mind this week. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being here. You guys know that I love you so much. And if you have just for the first time stumbled upon my channel and this video, I would love to extend you the invitation to become a part of this little internet tribe. My name is Katie and I do weekly, bi-weekly, monthly readings for most signs. Honestly, the weeklies I do for the signs that have most views, but Gemini is always one of them so far. So if you guys want to continue to get your weekly readings, just make sure to show activity, show me that you're there, show me that you're watching. Comment, like, subscribe, tag people, share, I don't know, whatever it is. So I know that you guys are there and that I can continue to do the weekly readings for you. So let's see. I don't do reversals either, in case that you are someone who loves reversals. I actually don't do reversals. So if you would like to find a reader that does, there's a lot of people doing this online that can be more resonant with you. Okay, we are ready to start. I'm using the Mermaid's Tarot, which I'm loving because I do have this kind of like affinity with Hawaii and the Hawaiian tradition, and this deck is very much aligned with that. We got the Four of Swords. Gemini, you are needing to rest, to recuperate, to rejuvenate, to take it easy. You need to take care of your physical body. You need to take care of your energy, your self-esteem, your solar plexus. Some of you guys need to sleep a whole lot more. You've been pushing yourself. You've been going hard in your life, and it's time for you to take a little bit of a break. And this week is the ideal week for that. What I'm getting is that some of you guys are going to do it voluntarily, and that's going to feel amazing. But if you try to resist this and try to work through it, it's very likely that you're going to feel so fatigued that you're going to have to do it anyway. But that might feel a little bit defeating or disempowering, okay? So choose to do it yourself. With the Ace of Wands here, there is a new beginning that is brewing under the surface. There is a new intention, a new desire, a new passion, a new beginning that is kind of like bubbling to the surface. What I'm seeing is like the bubbles when you're boiling water. They're kind of like beginning to show. And you need to take some rest this week. It's especially important because this is around the corner. And for this, you're going to need a lot of energy, okay? And you need to be ready. You don't want to receive that opportunity feeling drained and tired. The Tower. So this opportunity that is coming in is going to bring in a complete shift and change of plans. Maybe you had a plan for what your life is going to look like this month, and then this new opportunity, this amazing opportunity comes in, and you're like, oh well, I guess I have to do some changes, but that can actually be better for me. So I do feel like you guys are feeling excited about the changes that are I don't know how would you describe this movement. Like a snake is kind of like crawling in, you know, I see that. Like the changes are kind of like crawling in. You're not necessarily making them actively, but you do know that the changes that are coming in are bringing in something better for you. And you can feel it. Yes, we have the Sun. Yay, you guys. I am super excited to be seeing this card in this reading. As a reader, every time I see the Sun, that for me is everything is going to be okay. You know, like that's a message that assures me with certainty that you are being guided into the ideal circumstances. But some changes might need to come through and you need to be well rested, you guys. This seems to be a very important week. Very important week that is going to shift your path in a different and better direction. Don't let that change catch you off guard. Don't let that change catch you feeling exhausted. You want to feel very recharged because it's gonna be a thing. It's gonna be a process, okay? With the Eight of Swords, the more, I feel like the more tired you are and the less self-care you have set in place, the more insecure you're gonna feel about this change. Let me use an example. Let's say you've been looking for a job, a new job, and you've been pushing yourself so hard to get this new job or get a job, and you're exhausted and you're not taking good care of yourself, you're not eating well, you're not sleeping well, you're not hydrated, you're not meditating, you're not working out. So your body is feeling very anxious, very stressed out, very drained, very negative. And then this opportunity comes in, there is a chance that you're gonna be feeling physically so heavy that you're not gonna even see that this is a blessing. It might even feel like, oh my God, that means I have to do more, you know? So make sure that this month, this week, finds you recharged. Even if you're watching this, you know, on June the 30th or 31st or whatever, tonight, just after reading after listening to this reading, make sure that you take a big, big glass of water and that you're hydrated. Make sure that you sleep well, sleep in, sleep a little bit more, you know, maybe take one of those tea time, sleep time teas for you to make sure that this night you're gonna really rest. Tomorrow, work out, get the energy moving, get the energy flowing, even if it's just go for a walk. But make sure that by the time this week comes, you are in a good physical space, okay? That is gonna make the whole difference. Otherwise, you might feel like this blessing is actually like some kind of punishment because of the perception and perspective that your body might be giving you. Yes, it is a blessing. It is such an important, beautiful blessing, you guys. The Ace of Pentacles, the Ace of Wands, the Sun. It is a new beginning. You're doing it. There's this new chapter that is coming in. I feel like it's very much related to your work and finances, your professional life, your passions, your hobbies, the things that you like. There is a new beginning that is going to kind of clear everything that has been and will bring in the new. But you need to be in good shape to receive it, guys. Seriously. We got the Eight of Pentacles. Amazing. All of the hard work that you have put in for months now is paying off. You have the rewards right in front of you. You can see them. Everybody around you can see them. You are well on your way to continue to manifest that which you've been fighting for a while. Okay? Great news. And we have the Three of Swords. There's definitely a healing process that you have been involved in. There's definitely wounds that you have been trying to address or overcome. There is deep sadness within you, maybe disappointment about something that has happened, maybe things that you feel are very heavy within your heart. Understand that those things are there and that they will be there until they are completely processed. Don't try to avoid them, don't try to run away from them. Just know that they're there and that they have a purpose. And understand that there's something beautiful trying to come in. And simply allow that to come in. Even if you feel like you're not completely healed, even if you feel like the situations have not been completely resolved, this is something that you have asked for and that it has, you know, arrived. So, yeah. This illustration is so sad. I can't help but feel so sad. It's like a whale that the mermaids have found to be dead. I don't think they killed it. I think that they found it and they're like really shaken by it. Very interesting. Very interesting. Okay, message for Gemini for the first week of July. I am free of whatever is holding me back. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Obsidian is a crystal that can help you this week if you like to work with crystals and you like to get support that way. Obsidian is going to be good for you. Basically black stones, because garnet is also showing up here. With the Three of Wands, I have the energy I need to realize my goals. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Final message. I choose my battles carefully. That is important, guys. Don't waste energy on things that are not important or the most important. It seems like you have limited energy, so you want to invest it very carefully in this new beginning and in the positive things, not in the negative, okay? So yeah, you guys, that's what I have for you this week. I hope that this reading is helpful. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would love to have you here. Please click on the little tippy on the corner of this video or on the subscription button below if you want to make my day and make me happy and smile. Know that I will if you subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you next week. Bye, Geminis.